live in a world that resides between our ears. There are many things we want to try, places we want to go, business ventures we want to pursue, things that we know we are called to do. But with daily challenges that enter our lives, those things start to look uncertain or scary or plain impossible. Whenever we think about those things, we get butterflies in our stomach or sweaty palms, you name it. And the uncertainty about how these things will impact our future can stir up so much more anxiety. Because again, we live in a world that lives between our ears. There, we can find one of our biggest cheerleaders or one of our harshest critics. That critic inside of our head that tells us that we're not good enough, that we are not prepared, that we don't have a certain look, or that we don't have a certain background. But that is where our courage comes in. Courage is the ability to do something that frightens you. It is mental or moral strength to persevere. We can look to the Bible for help with providing our courage, to quiet that critic. The Bible is full of stories about people who faced and overcame very tough situations. People doing courageous things with the help of God. For example, in Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10, the Lord tells the people of Israel, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." Or turn to the book of Ezra. In that book, Ezra writes about an extraordinary amount of power and responsibility given to him by a king. However, instead of giving credit to the king for the success, in chapter 7, verse 28, he gave that credit to God by saying, "I took courage, for the hand of the Lord my God was on me, and I gathered leading men from Israel to go up with me." Or how about 1 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 20? While as David was encouraging his son, he told him, "Son, be strong and courageous, and do the work. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord God, my God, is with you. He will not fail you or forsake you until all the work for the service of the temple of the Lord is finished." Now take a moment to think. Where is your courage? What is stopping you? What are you afraid of? What is holding you back? God speaks to us all in a very personal way. He may have put an idea or solution in your heart that is specifically for you, but you have not taken that first or maybe that next step. Now might be the time for you to take one of these scriptures and repeat it. And then repeat it again. Let the wisdom of the scripture give you confidence and, yes, give you courage. Now may be the time to find that courage. It may be time to silence that critic between your ears and replace it with the more powerful voice of God. If you are not ready to take that first step alone, reach out to someone that can take that first step with you. this may be your time to stand out and be the brave, courageous person you were meant to be. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, there are situations in my life that make me afraid. I worry that things will not turn out well. Continue to remind me that you have not given me a spirit of fear, but a spirit of strength to pursue whatever it is I need to do. Please assure me that for better or for worse, you will always be with me. I need this courage and cannot do it without you, God. In your name we pray. Amen.